Hello, my followers, to the world of sommelier. This is your guide.
Corrigor.
Tonight is a special night for a few reasons. It is the last episode of the 10 years in a bottle of wine series, and it is the last longer video in the history of Corbreaker.
Maybe
I will also make some posts on Instagram and some reels, but overall it is the beginning of the end.
I hate goodbyes.
I learned a lot, grew up as a wine-oriented guy, tried some rare wines, some old wines, and some single vineyard wines. So overall, if I would go back 4 years from now, I would do everything exactly the same, and I would advise every wine lover at least try to be a wine influencer. You will not lose anything and you will win more than you could imagine. Last winery is the shining star and the leader of the Umbria region called Lungarotti. Even though the Lungarotti family produced wine and olive oil for centuries, the revolutionary changes began with Giorgio Lungarotti. 1936, he obtained a degree in agriculture, and after experimentation and reshaping its vineyard, in 1962, he created famous Rubesco and Torre di Giano wines. In year 2000, the family acquired a 20-hectare estate in Montefalco zone, which, thanks to the Giorgio, was promoted to DOC in 1979. Now, two family estates, Torgiano and Montefalco, combined to 250 hectares, which converts into 29 different labels, producing an average 2.5 million bottles a year. Since 1999, with the passing away of their father, the company has been guided by his daughters Chiara and Teresa. Teresa's son Francesco and daughter Gemma have also joined the company after finishing their studies. Maria Grazia, the wife of Giorgio, is a director of non-profit Lungarotti Foundation and a founder of Wine Museum of Torgiano and the Museum of Olive and Oil. Talking about tonight's San Giorgio wine, it belongs to the Umbria Indicazione Geografica Tipica category, and this should be thankful for Giorgio Lungarotti and his continuous desire to experiment. In 1977, with a combination of Cabernet Sauvignon, Sangiovese, and Cannaiolo, he created the first super Umbrian wine. On the label, you can see Saint George against Dragon, which is detailed from the famous Raffaello painting in tribute to the traditional feast day of Saint George on April 23rd, where the custom still alive today is to light propitiatory bonfires in the vineyards around Torgiano. Wine is fermented in stainless steel for 25 to 28 days with skins, aged in oak barrels for 1 year and rested in bottle for another year. Talking about this decade, some serious changes happened. First of all, 2007 was the last vintage for the San Giorgio Cabernet Sauvignon grapes. After the harvest, vines were root out. Then after soil was ready, they replanted the vines, and only 2016 was ready for the San Giorgio Reserve wine. In the same decade, they have replanted not just Cabernet Sauvignon, but also the rest 230 hectares of Torgiano vineyards. Winery also switched to organic cultivation in 2010 and received organic certification in 2014. Comparing these two wines, 2007 is a blend of 50% Cabernet Sauvignon, 40% Sangiovese, and 10% Cannaiolo, and 2017 is a 50% Cabernet and 50% Sangiovese. About the oak, 2007 was aged in equal parts of new 1 and 2 year old barrique, while 2017 was aged 50% in 50 hectoliter big casks, and other 50% variation in new and 1 year old barriques. Also, bottle aging before wine release on the market in 2007 was at least 6 years, and in 2017 changed to at least 1 year. 2007 as a vintage had summer temperatures well above the average, with significant decrease in September, but overall at the end of September, harvest was completed with perfectly healthy grapes, while 2017 had even hotter summer, reaching 40 degrees degrees Celsius and having rainfall 50% lower than average. This led to the low yields and early harvest. Comparing to these vintages, one of the best was 2010, which was considered as cool and not hot, but this is only in favor of Sangiovese, while Cabernet Sauvignon likes it hot. What about in the rest of the world? According to the Robert Parker, 2007 seems to be above average, with a few exceptions like Châteauneuf du Pape, Brunello di Montalcino, and Vintage Porto, while 2017 looks also like an above average, highlighting Burgundy White and again Vintage Porto. After this, let's see how they look in the glass. Starting with the 2017, it has a medium intensity cherry color nose, has medium plus intensity aromas of ripe cherries, blackcurrant, strawberries, cherry jam, old oak, freshly cut wood, attic, and beef jerky. Mouth has medium acidity, medium plus alcohol, strong and balanced tannins. On the palate, dried black berries. 2007 has medium plus intensity cherry color nose. Has medium intensity aromas of ripe cherries, cherry stones, blackcurrant, raspberries, blueberry jam, figs, and vanilla. Mouth has medium minus acidity, medium alcohol, and mature, elegant tannins. On the palate, pie filled with prunes and rabbit.
Conclusions:
two different wines representing two different vineyards and two different times. But just to see how well aged 2007, coming from pretty crappy vintage, I would definitely give 2017 10 more years. So that's it, guys. Thanks to those wineries who believed in me. Thank you all for watching, commenting, and liking. Tell me in the comments if you ever tried Lungarotti production. Like and follow. Salute, Steve.